Hello guys, I hope you all are doing well. Today is Friday, so 2014 video, and we'll complete 10 questions today, which will make us reach 70. Then we do not have 3 weeks to go, but I'll try completing all the 30 questions by this year, so that when we start 2021, we start 2015's paper, and accordingly we proceed with our question paper analysis, our MCQ analysis, and then we complete and move into the mock exams and everything. So let's begin. The first question for today's video is, if the interest rate is decreased in an economy, it will decrease the consumption expenditure. No, why will that be there? Increase the tax collection of the government? I think it's not with the interest rate, it's more with the demand and the public spending, and increase the investment expenditure in the economy is the right answer, because if the interest rate is decreased, you would have an incentive to take a loan or invest in the market. So C is the correct answer. Then we have, consider the following statements. The president shall make rules for more convenient transaction of the business and for the allocation among the ministries of the said business. Yes, the president has the powers. All executive actions of the government of India shall be expressed to be taken in the name of the prime minister. No. India follows the parliamentary principle in which president is the titular head, though all the work is done by the prime minister in council of ministers under article 74. So the correct answer is A1 only. Then we have, consider the following statements, again a polity question. Regarding a no confidence motion in India, there is no mention of the no confidence motion in the Constitution of India. Yes. A motion of no confidence can be introduced in the Lok Sabha only. Yes. So yes, these both are correct, because a motion of no confidence cannot be issued in the Rajya Sabha, and once it's issued, once it's introduced, and after that, if it declines, if it gets away, or it's passed, it's complete clear that it's passed, then the Lok Sabha people have to give up, the government dissolves. So the correct answer is C, both 1 and 2. Then we have another question with reference to neem tree. So now you need to know that if you have trees, you need to know their benefits, the disadvantages, their way, their scope of using it in AI, in using it in things which are man-made or something like that. So the first is, neem oil can be used as a pesticide to control the proliferation of some species of insects and mites. Neem seeds are used in the manufacture of biofuels and hospital detergents. Neem oil has applications in pharmaceutical industry. We'll have to see what all are correct and accordingly answer. For the first thing, neem oil extracted by cold pressing the seed kernels of neem. So the presence of disulfide in neem oil is a major contributor to its bioactivity, and this statement makes our first option correct. So in that answer, we have the first option as correct. Then we have that the seeds of neem contain 30 to 40% oil, and biodiesel obtained from neem oil, which are monoalkyl esters, and thus the neem seeds are also used as hospital detergents. So this makes our second option correct. But if you look at the UPSC answer key, it has the first statement and the third statement as correct. So the basic conclusion that we can find is that within these years, this has been used here, but at that point of time, 2014, maybe this option wasn't there. The third option is, neem oil used in pharmaceutical industries as it contains various compounds that have medicinal, cosmetic and insecticidal. So ultimately, we have for 64, the correct answer here would be D, 1, 2 and 3 right now, but UPSC answer key has us at 64 C, that is 1 and 3 only. Then we move to our next question, which reads as, which one of the following is the process involved in photosynthesis? So this is something we've been reading since class 3, class 2, but you will be shocked, because the first is potential energy is released to form free energy. Second is free energy is converted to potential energy and stored. Food is oxidized to release carbon dioxide and water, and oxygen is taken and carbon dioxide and water vapor are given out. So initially we just known D, but water vapor is not the solution there. So correct answer is B. Then we have, in addition to fingerprint scanning, which of the following can be used in the biometric identification of a person? This has been introduced now in a very good local level too, but initially it was just started with all the, you know, elite classes using them and things were that way going on. So now we know that yes, implementation is possible here. And the first option is iris scanning, retinal scanning and voice recognition. The correct answer is yes, D1, 2 and 3, all correct. Then we have, which of the following statements are correct regarding vegetative propagation of plants? So vegetative propagation produces clonal population, it helps in eliminating the virus and it can be practiced most of the year. So before knowing which answer is correct or which answer is incorrect, let's first at least know what is vegetative propagation. And here with this answer, you'll know that not everything is provided to you in your answers. You need to also use your mind. So yes, when we look at vegetative propagation, the basic common concept is that it is the asexual form of reproduction wherein part of plant other than seeds are used for the production of new plants, and these are also via natural and artificial. So if it's mentioning artificial, so clonal is possible. So the first statement is correct. Second statement is very stupid because yes, it's not used for any control or eliminating of any viruses. So yes, it's not correct. And the third is also correct, that yes, it can be practiced most of the year, because when we have artificial, that's like possible anywhere, everywhere, with just certain side effects or disadvantages. So 67, the correct answer is C, 1 and 3 only, the second option being incorrect. Then we have, which of the following pairs is or are correctly matched? We have spacecraft, and for what were they launched is the purpose given here. So we have Cassini-Huygens, we have Messenger, we have Voyager 1 and 2, and we need to know whether the options that are mentioned beside them is correct or not, whether they are matched properly or not. So the first says orbiting the Venus and transmitting data, second says mapping, investigating Mercury, and the third says exploring the outer solar system. So commonly called Cassini is the Cassini-Huygens, involved a collaboration. It's between NASA, European Space Agency and Italian Space Agency, and their work is to send a space probe. Yes, so that's correct, but to study the planet Saturn and its system, including their rings and the natural satellites. So Cassini-Huygens is for your Saturn and it's not for Venus. So the first option goes incorrect. Before knowing the second option, let's look into more about the Cassini-Huygens. Yes, NASA is having the Cassini space probe, and European Space Agency is having the Huygens lander, and which landed on Saturn's largest moon, Titan. Cassini was the fourth space probe to visit the Saturn, and the two craft took their names from the astronomers Giovanni Cassini and Christian Huygens. This is something which was a basic information, may or may not be asked. Then we have Messenger, a NASA robotic space probe orbited the planet Mercury. So yes, this option is correct, and this name is a backronym for Mercury Surface Space Environment Geochemistry and Ranging, and from there it gets its name Mercury, and it also is a reference to the messenger god Mercury from Roman mythology. So yes, Messenger Mercury is correct. Then we have the Voyager 1 and 2. Their original mission was to study only the planetary systems of Jupiter, Saturn, but they continued to Uranus, Neptune, and they now explore the outer boundary of the heliosphere in interstellar space, and mission extended 3 times, and now neither Uranus nor Neptune has had a closer picture taken by a probe other than Voyager 2. So ultimately they now explore the outer boundary is important, which makes our answer known. Yes, that's also correct. So the first option, that is Cassini-Huygens and Messenger and Voyager 1 and 2, in this one is incorrect because it's not Venus, it is Saturn, and Messenger is correct, Mercury, and Voyager 1 and 2 is correct, exploring the outer solar system. Which now leaves us with the option 2 and 3, which is B. So 68B, 2 and 3 is only the correct answer. Then we have We move on to the last second question for today. Consider the following pairs. We have region and we have their production. So now you know it's not just about you knowing where it is produced or something like that. You also know to know where are the regions, because most of the time when you look into the production, they will give you an area geographically and not according to the state wise. So you might have Southeast Asia, you might have just the southern coast or something like that, but it wouldn't tell you all the direct states and everything. So let's look into the areas and know, because yes, areca nut production is dominant in the coastal region. Like I said, it tells you about the places and everything. So it's there in most of the areas of the coastal area, which, and now it's also a tropical crop, which is popularly known as betel nut. So now you need to know about the nuts also. You now need to know about the areas they are produced and what are actually produced. So when you look at Kinnaur, because you need to also see whether Kinnaur is where or not, because see, Kinnaur is still a recognized place, a tourist attraction. But if you get a district which is not that recognized, that'll be a problem. So Kinnaur is not producing areca nut. And now if you look at mangoes, it's produced in a lot of places and it has different names in different places. So let's look into whether in Mewat it's there. See, Meos are the predominant population group and are all agriculturists. Agriculture is mostly rain fed, like in, you know, small pockets where also canal irrigation is available. So the main occupation is agriculture, and in that also a lot of irrigation is provided and everything. If you look at the Mewat district, you know, it's in the borderline of Rajasthan and Haryana. It's in the northernmost portion there. And in Haryana, it's mentioned, like, you know, if you look where is Mewat located, it's in Haryana. So here again, this is incorrect. And then you have soyabean. Soyabean is very clear where all it's produced. Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, majority. Then Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Chhattisgarh and Gujarat. So here all are the places where soyabean is produced and which does not have Coromandel Coast. So again, this answer goes incorrect. So the correct answer is we have Kinnaur, Mewat, Coromandel, which all three are incorrect. So the correct answer is D, none of them. We have the last question for today. Which of the following is or are the example or examples of chemical change? Very, very, very easy question. And a question from the NCRT. So a proof that yes, UPSC does refer to NCRTs. So crystallization of sodium chloride, no, that's a physical change. Melting of ice, no, again, that's a physical change because it gives you water then. And souring of milk, this is a chemical change because it includes fermentation. So this is three only. Alright guys, this was it with today's video. Friday's videos are a little knowledgeable and it gives me a lot of confidence to just go through the MCQ papers, because this is gonna decide what would your paper be like, or what would your paper, the pattern would be like. And moreover, it, you know, gives you an enlightenment of what to study and what to just miss out, and how tough could be your question paper be, because see, they have easy questions like asking just about physical and chemical changes, but they also have tough questions like, you know, you have Mewat district you might have just not ever heard of. So this way you need to keep your syllabus uptight, preparation going, and accordingly need to proceed with your things, and then we can somehow cover up the mocks, the question papers, and proceed with our preparation. The end would be decided by them, not us. So let's not focus there. Let's focus on our journey and think how would we reach there. We meet next tomorrow. Until then, keep studying, keep knowing more, and thanks for watching.